إبراهيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, we are approaching the end of the month of Ramadan. In a few days time, we will be celebrating the Eid al-Fitr for all Muslim and Muslimah. It is indeed a sad moment for all of us because Ramadan is leaving us soon. And not only Ramadan has taught us many lessons, Ramadan has purified us physically and spiritually. And not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it an obligation for us to fast for 30 days or so in the month of Ramadan to purify ourselves, but also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it an obligatory for us to pay Zakat al-Fitr. And don't forget about the Zakat al-Fitr, because this is also a commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zakat al-Fitr, or Zakat of breaking the fast of Ramadan, is a special obligatory alms paid by all Muslims at the end of Ramadan fasting month. And it is mandatory charity due on every Muslim at the end of Ramadan, regardless of age and gender. Its obligatory payment is termed fitrah. So the word fitrah derived from Arabic terms called fitr, right? Just like we break our fast is iftar. Fitr, same Arabic words, Arabic terms, a word which signifies the nature. Fitrah is nature upon which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created human being. Related also to the word, Arabic word, fast breaking. I mean, you're breaking your fast is iftar. It is all related. You see, all the relation. Eating after a period of abstention from this natural and defining human activities. And this is the relation between Zakat al-Fitrah and iftar and fitr nature. So the obligation to pay for Zakat al-Fitr at Ramadan, it was revealed in the month of Ramadan, the ninth month in Islamic lunar calendar. So this is also a part of the obligation that Muslims need to fulfill apart from fasting. And we know that to achieve taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, La'allakum tattaqoon, so that you can be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The taqwa here, not only it is to be achieved through fasting, but also the obligatory of zakat. Zakat is derived from the word tazkiyah. Tazkiyah is also to purify. So we know that in Islam, zakat is to purify ourselves, to purify our wealth, to purify our spiritual and physical. And for Ramadan is month of purification. Ramadan, towards the end of Ramadan, we will reborn. We will be just like as clean, as beautiful, as pure as a newborn baby. That is why in towards the end of Ramadan and the beginning of Eid, people will always give greetings, min al a'idin wal faizin wal maqbulin, that we hope that we will become from those who are achieve a victory, the victory to stop, the victory to abstain, from all our humanly needs throughout the month of Ramadan. Min al-a'idin wal-fa'izin wal-maqbulin, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our good deeds. And this is also achieved. Okay, the purification is achieved by fasting and zakat fitrah. I urge all Muslims, brothers and sisters out there, do not forget the zakat al-fitr. As much as we focus on our fasting, our Ramadan, our Qiyamul Layl, our reading of Quran, yes, alhamdulillah, those are fantastic, those are good, but don't forget another obligatory amal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has us to do, which is to pay Zakat al-Fitr, inshaAllah. تبارك الله تعالى. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.